Now that you have created your new QuickBooks Online account, let's do the setup steps to prepare it for an Amazon online store. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Here are the basic QuickBooks Online account setup steps to fast track setting up an Amazon online merchant store using QuickBooks Online. Just to remind you, this video assumes that your only business in QuickBooks Online is your Amazon online merchant store. If you do additional business, you may need to watch additional QuickBooks Online videos right here on this website. The setup will be relatively fast and abbreviated. That means there will be a clear demonstration, but not big elaboration or detailed discussion after each step. If you want more detail, then again, you may have to watch additional videos. So here are the four main steps to follow to prepare your new QuickBooks Online account for a QuickBooks Amazon merchant store. First, you have to create the new QuickBooks Online account. I will be demonstrating everything with the Accountant's Edition, but you should be able to follow if you're using the 30-day free trial plus version. Then you have to put in your company information, and I'll show you how to do that in the account settings window. Then we will put in our Amazon chart of accounts, and then we will set up the reports that you will need to manage your merchant store. So you may well ask, what is the chart of accounts? Well, in the old days, the chart of accounts was called the general ledger. And the general ledger was a book where each page in the book was a separate record of a category of transactions. And the record of that category of transactions was called an account. So the chart of accounts means that an account is a record of a set of transactions. And you will need an account for every bank account, credit card account, source of income, and expense that your Amazon online merchant store will have. You may need some more accounts. The chart of accounts window will allow you to add, edit, and delete or make inactive any account in the chart of accounts if your situation is slightly different than our example. The total accumulated results of the chart of accounts show in a report called the trial balance. So here are the accounts that an Amazon store would need. You need one account for each item on the bi-monthly statement that Amazon gives you twice a month when they dump your proceeds from your Amazon sales into your bank account. You need an account called Product Charges, and that's an income account, and it represents your gross sales on Amazon. You will need an account called Promo Rebates, because that's something that they deduct from your sales and they list it separately on the statements. You will need an account for Amazon fees for the same reason. FBA fees are also deducted from your income and listed clearly on the statement. Subscription fees also deducted and listed clearly on your statement. And cost of advertising. And something called other. These are all things that deduct or add to the main sales income and are listed individually on the statement, and that's why you need an account for each of these. You also, or most of you, will also need another account called Unavailable Balance. And the Unavailable Balance is a current asset. And as you know, it's the amount that Amazon knows that you are entitled to, but withholds from the bi-monthly payout. And it's a different amount each month. And you have to have an account for that so that you can keep track of it and make sure Amazon is paying you the correct amount. So, here are the accounts that you would need. Now, this is a picture of the desktop version of the accounts you would need. It looks very similar in QuickBooks Online, and this is the list we will look back at and follow when we add the accounts that we need. Please keep in mind, QuickBooks Online comes with a large set of accounts in your chart of accounts that they give you at the beginning. You can remove the ones that you don't need, but all we will do is add the specific accounts that we do need. So here we are in our new account that we created with QuickBooks Online. To put your name, we would click here and we would go to Company Settings. It might also say Account Settings. Click here and notice there are different categories of settings. This window is where the defaults and options are to control how the entire account behaves. Click the category of Company, then go all the way to the right and click the pencil tool and type in the name. I will type in My Amazon Store. But you can type in whatever name you like for your company. And now we're done. Now we'll input the chart of accounts. Scroll down from the panel on the left and click Accounting, Chart of Accounts. Now, if it's the very first time you're going to the chart of accounts, they make you click this button, See the Chart of Accounts. And these are the accounts that automatically came with QuickBooks Online. Your list might be slightly different from mine because you might have chosen a different version, used a different browser, or set up the account from a different country. So there might be some small details that are different. But most importantly, these are the accounts and the account types that we're going to add. First, you have to add your bank account. So you would click New from the top right, and the type would be bank, and the detail type, by the way, the detail type is usually irrelevant, but we might as well do it the correct way and choose checking, and then put the name of your bank or any name that you know represents the balance of your bank account. I use Chase Bank as an example. They're a very good bank. And then if you click Save and Close, you will see that QuickBooks Online has added the account to the list in the chart of accounts. Well, what else do we need? Well, we need the Unavailable Balance account to be an other current asset. So we click New, and we choose Other Current, where is it? Other Current Asset. And again, the detail type is not always relevant, but we'll put the closest one. The closest one would just be other current asset, and we'll call this, what Amazon calls this, unavailable balance. And then, of course, we don't have to click Save and Close after each one. We can click Save and New. And just trust me, the account is there in the chart of accounts. So I'm only going to click Save and New from now on to save time. What about, now we can skip opening balance, equity, and retained earnings. These are already given to us on the list of the accounts when QuickBooks Online created your account. So we'll just focus on the ones that are on the Amazon statement, starting with your main income account, product charges. So this is an income type of account, and the income is sales of product, and you call it what Amazon calls it. And then, of course, save and new. What else? Amazon fees and everything else is an expense. So we choose expense. And what type of expense? Well, again, the detail type is usually not relevant. So we will just put general administrative expenses and we'll type in Amazon fees, save and new. Now, what else? Cost of advertising. So that's also an expense. General administrative. And we'll name it what Amazon names it. Save and new. What else? Well, FBA fees, whatever that is, you have to pay it. So general, we'll assume it's general administrative. Save and new. What else? Other, you have to put it in there because Amazon has it. So that's an expense. General administrative, other, save and new. We have promo rebates, expense, general administrative, save and new. We're almost done with the chart of accounts. Subscription fees, save and new. And the last one I put, it's not related to Amazon, but there will be a video later showing you how to manage general non-Amazon related expenses. So let's go ahead and put utilities. Okay, general administrative. Okay, very good. Now your chart of accounts. Oh, it's already on the list, so forget it. So now we have your chart of accounts that includes the accounts that Amazon, that QuickBooks Online gave you, plus the accounts for Amazon. Now, please note, if you have any additional items that are listed on your bi-monthly Amazon deposit statement, you will have to add an expense type of account to the chart of accounts for anything that was not mentioned here. In other words, your chart of accounts must match the statement. Now, the last thing you have to do is prepare your reports and shortcuts to the only two relevant reports that you will need if you have an Amazon online store: the trial balance and the profit and loss. And the only thing we will customize is making the dates show us the result of all transactions, regardless of date. So this is how you do it. In the left panel, you click Reports. Now, you don't have any custom reports, but the two that we will set up will be right here in Custom Reports, so you can get there faster. To open them up in the first place, click Standard, and go down to Trial Balance. Trial balance. That's all the way at the bottom if you're an accountant, but be careful, check every single one to find the one that says trial balance. Now, of course, it's empty because we have not yet recorded transactions. Click the pull down date range menu Choose all dates and click Run Report. Now that it looks the way we need it to look, click Save Customization and then click Save. Now when you click Reports, all you have to do is go to the Custom Report area and you will see the trial balance exactly as we created it. Now again click Reports, go to the Standard area of Reports, and go all the way down to the only other report that's necessary, Profit and Loss. So let's see if we can, I think it's up top here. No, it's not Who Owes You. Yeah, it's in the Business Overview, Profit and Loss Detail. Profit and Loss Detail. Click there. Again, click the Date pull-down menu and click All Dates. Then Run Report so that you can see the results of all transactions regardless of date. Then click Save Customization and click Save. Now, when you click Reports, all you have to do is go to the Custom area and you go directly to the only two reports that are necessary if all you're doing is buying and selling on Amazon, and they're much easier to find and they already have the date range set the way we need. Congratulations, you are ready to start recording transactions from your bi-monthly Amazon statement.